Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create an awesome double exposure portrait effect. I provided this image of trees that you can download for this project, but feel free to use another photo if you like. I also provided this high contrast black and white image of clouds that we'll apply later. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, smash that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. I upload a new one every week. Open a photo of a face that we'll use to blend in with the other photo. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to separate our subject from the background. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, let's use the Quick Selection tool. Drag the tool over your subject to select it. If you need to remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To refine its edges, go to Select. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2015.5, click Refine Edge. If you're using a later version, click Select and Mask. If you prefer to use Refine Edge, Shift-click Select and Mask. I did in-depth tutorials on both filters, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. Check Smart Radius. This detects smooth and hard edges. Brush over the edge of your subject's hair. Then output it to a layer mask. If you're using CC 2018 or later, rather than dragging your tool over your subject to select it, just click the Select Subject button. This automatically selects your subject. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. Open your other photo. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2021, use the Quick Selection tool to select the foreground. If you're using CC 2021 or later, go to Edit and Sky Replacement. Drag the Fade Edge slider all the way to the left to get rid of the fade between the sky and the foreground. Then click OK. Make the sky active and click the foreground color. Pick a solid color to replace the sky. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field. After you pick your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Notice our foreground color is the color we just picked. To fill the sky with this color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Double-click the layer mask next to the solid color to open its properties. Make the contrast 10% and shift the edge to 20%. Then click OK. We'll convert our visible image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, which will allow us to change the color of the background at any point. Let's collapse the folder and shift-click the original photo to make it active as well. Click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll place it onto the face by pressing V to open our Move tool and dragging it onto the tab of the face document. Without releasing our mouse or pen, drag it down and release. We'll resize and position it, but first, we'll reduce its opacity so we can see the face under it. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To resize it, go to a corner and drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return, or click the check mark at the top. Increase its opacity back to 100%. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J and temporarily hide it. Make the original layer active and change its blend mode to darken. We'll copy the layer mask onto the active layer by pressing and holding Alt or Option as we drag the copy of the layer mask next to the active layer. Make the subject active. We'll make a new layer below it by Ctrl or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with the foreground color by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Next, we'll fade in the eyes, nose, and mouth of the original face. Make the layer mask active next to your scenery photo and open your brush tool. open your brush picker and pick a soft round brush. We'll adjust the size in a moment. The hardness is 0%, the opacity is approximately 35%, and the flow is 100%. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the eyes, nose, and mouth. The reason it's revealing the original face is because we're actually brushing black over the layer mask. The black areas in the layer mask are hiding or concealing those areas of the scenery layer next to it, which is revealing the face under it. Make the head active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click black and white. We want the black and white adjustment layer to affect just the head. However, since adjustment layers affect all the layers under them in the layers panel, we'll need to clip the adjustment layer to the head. To do this, click the clipping mask icon or go to Layer and create clipping mask. Next, we'll deepen the contrast of the face by opening the black and white preset list and clicking maximum black. Make the top layer visible and active. We'll make an inverted layer mask next to it by Alt or Option clicking the layer mask icon. This hides the top layer. We'll reveal back areas of it by brushing white over the layer mask. Invert the foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard so white is your foreground color. Increase the opacity to 100% and brush over the top of the head to reveal the scenery photo. To feather it out, reduce your brush's opacity and continue to brush over your subject. If you want to retain hard edges along the head, Control or Command click the layer mask next to the head to select it. Brush over the areas of the scenery. The areas of the scenery that will be revealed will be restricted to the inside of the head. Then deselect it. Open the clouds file I provided. Open your Move tool and drag the clouds onto the tab of the double exposure image. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Change its blend mode to screen and open your transform tool. At the top, make sure the chain link icon is active between the transform's width and height. This will retain its aspect ratio as we drag the scrubby slider in either field to the left to reduce the cloud size. Reposition it and press Enter or Return. Make an inverted layer mask to hide the clouds and open back your brush tool. Reduce the brush's opacity and brush in the clouds. Feel free to readjust its opacity and invert the colors to hide areas of the clouds. Reposition it if you like. Lastly, we'll brighten our entire image by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking Levels. Drag the input highlights level to the left. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.